सुशांत सिंह राजपूत केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट से सेंट्रल ब्यूरो ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन यानी सीबीआई जांच को अनुमति मिलने के बाद महाराष्ट्र सरकार ने यह आश्वासन दिया है कि उनकी पुलिस जांच में पूरा सहयोग करेगी। इसी के साथ कहा जा रहा है कि मुंबई पुलिस इस केस में अपना पैरेलल जांच भी जारी रखेगी। इस केस की जांच में जुटी सीबीआई की टीम आज मुंबई पहुंचेगी और केस से जुड़े सबूतों को इकट्ठा करने का काम शुरू करेगी। हालांकि इस केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट के फैसले के बाद महाराष्ट्र सरकार और मुंबई पुलिस को काफी फजीहत झेलनी पड़ी, लेकिन कोर्ट के जजमेंट के कुछ घंटे बाद ही काफी विचार विमर्श के बाद गृह मंत्री अनिल देशमुख मीडिया के सामने आए। उन्होंने कहा, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने मुंबई पुलिस की जांच को सही ठहराया है और कहा है कि ये जांच बेहद प्रोफेशनल तरीके से की गई है। हालांकि इस केस में सीबीआई जांच को अहमियत दी गई है। उन्होंने कहा, हम सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जजमेंट का स्वागत करते हैं और सीबीआई को इस जांच में जिस तरह की भी सहयोग की जरूरत होगी हम जरूर देंगे। मुंबई पुलिस के लिए गर्व की बात है कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उनकी जांच में कोई कमी नहीं पाई।
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑर्डर्ड सीबीआई प्रोब इन सुशांत सिंह राजपूत डेथ केस। उद्धव सरकार हैज नाउ गॉट जिटरी। इन अनदर बिड टू स्टॉल एंड सप्रेस, मुंबई पुलिस हैज प्रॉमिस्ड अ पैरेलल प्रोब इन द केस एंड दिस कम्स अमिड शिवसेना स्टॉन्च डिफेंस ऑफ द इन्वेस्टिगेशन बाय द मुंबई पुलिस। इन इट्स एडिटोरियल सामना, शिवसेना क्लेम दैट मुंबई पुलिस इज ऑनेस्ट एंड दैट दे मस्ट कंटिन्यू देयर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इन द केस। सेना ऑल्सो हिट आउट एट द बिहार गवर्नमेंट एंड कॉल द ट्रांसफर ऑफ केस एन इंसल्ट टू प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ बाला साहेब ठाकरे। नाउ दिस डिस्पाइट द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैंडिंग ओवर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन टू द सेंट्रल ब्यूरो ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन। सीबीआई विल नाउ बी कैरिंग आउट द इन्वेस्टिगेशन सुशांत सिंह राजपूत डेथ केस। दे वुड बी सेंडिंग देयर टीम टू द मैक्सिमम सिटी वेयर द बीएमसी हैज नाउ सेड दैट द सीबीआई विल हैव टू इन्फॉर्म द बीएमसी ऑफिशियल्स अबाउट देयर विजिट सो दैट if it's less than 7 days they won't be quarantined. Let's go across to my colleague senior editor Bhavtosh joins us along with our Mumbai bureau chief Kajal Iyer. Let me first go across to Kajal. What really is the Shiv Sena trying to prove here by saying that the Mumbai police will continue its parallel investigation despite the Supreme Court allowing the CBI to go ahead?
Well, right now the Supreme Court verdict, there is a fact that if a cognizable offence is registered, then all of those cognizable offences will go to the CBI. In this case, an FIR. Given the fact that the Mumbai Police still has an ADR, this is the loophole that they are trying to use. They are going to continue investigating the ADR under Section 174 and try and file some sort of a conclusion report or a closure report on that particular ADR. That seems to be the strategy right now to try and perhaps use this as a face saver that, you know, they still are part of the case, given the fact that certain observations in the Supreme Court were heartening to them. They felt that given the fact that that no questions as such were raised on the investigation by the Supreme Court order, and that is why they can go ahead with this. But of course, the moment a closure report is filed, one of two things happen in the case of an ADR. Either they conclude that it is a suicide and so they close the case, or they file a cognizable offense in the form of an FIR and ask for abetment and other charges which are to be put for suicide. Mm-hmm. And in the case of murder, the charges of murder. Now, whether or not they are planning to do that in the future, that remains a question right now.
Right, Kajal, stay on with us. We also have Vajiullah on the broadcast, but before that, let's go across to our senior editor, Bhavtosh. As Kajal was also highlighting and the Supreme Court made it clear, any new development in terms of registration of a case in this entire issue will again be directed towards the CBI. Now, speaking purely on the legal terms, is the Mumbai police, you know, right as far as carrying out a parallel investigation is concerned? Is Shiv Sena right in saying that? Also, wouldn't this lead to another turf war like we witnessed between the Mumbai police and the Bihar police?
Swati, the fact is that the Supreme Court order is very clear. The probe has to be carried out by the Central Bureau of Investigation, and the judge had in fact gave a very detailed judgment as to why the probe should be carried out by the CBI. Now, if Mumbai Police goes ahead with the inquest proceeding, it can be used by a defense to say that they have not committed any crime and that they are in fact being given a clean chit by the Mumbai police, and this can be used by them in court of law, and no criminal investigation can have a two parallel probes. Now that is completely illegal, and more importantly, Swati, CBI SIT has made it very clear that they will examine two Mumbai police officers who are directly in the dock. One of them was in fact the officer who received the WhatsApp from OP Singh, Faridabad police commissioner, and also Sushant's brother-in-law. He in fact never pursued that case very seriously. And the second is the present DCP of Bandra. He's someone who was in direct touch with the prime suspect or the person of interest in this case, that is Riha Chakravarti. The question is why senior police officers were in touch with someone who is already under investigation. And interestingly, in the inquest proceedings of Mumbai police, at no point of time OP Singh's WhatsApp was taken on record. And the family, when they recorded their statement twice in past 10 days, have said it and formally made a complaint with CBI, and that's the reason why CBI has decided to examine these two police officers. And it could be possible that Mumbai police is carrying out a parallel probe primarily to save senior IPS officers who are implicated in this case.
Bureau report, Nav Bharat Times.